This is the Segway X160, an electric dirt bike that has a top speed of 31 miles per hour with plenty of torque and acceleration so it can sprint from 0 to 30 in 4 seconds. The X160 features a well-designed and lightweight frame while being powerful and nimble and at the same time very quiet, so you can ride in more places where you normally can't take a dirt bike. For ordering the bike, one of the advantages of the X160 is that it's available on Amazon, and we ordered it when it was on sale for $3,000 instead of the $3,500 retail. Also, with Amazon, you have a 30-day return window if you don't like it, and with an Amazon Prime card, you can either save 5% or get free financing for 18 months. We also found it on sale at other sites for $3,000 with coupon codes that will save you money. We'll put all the links and best deals in the description of the video. Our X160 shipped quickly from Amazon through UPS and arrived in just 3 days. It ships in a large box with the bike mostly assembled. Along with the bike, you get the front fender, two pegs, a set of tools, the charger, and a set of two keys for the bike. They also include a metal card that has all the proper torque specs. For the initial setup, the front wheel needs to be installed, which requires removing the axle, placing the spacers, and lining up the wheel. The next step is setting up the top handlebar. This requires first lining up the bar and screwing it in, and then doing each side of the handlebar with the throttle, brakes, and grips. The last step is adding the front fender, along with the pegs on each side. Finally, you add the battery, plug it in, and it's ready to ride. The X160 also has Bluetooth and a phone app, which is a unique feature that the Surons do not have. When you first set up the app, you can easily connect and pair the bike. You then have to activate the bike, create an account, and go through the safety and instructions on how to use the bike. Once in the app, you can see the range and battery remaining. You can also quickly adjust the speed modes, which includes the twisting force of the throttle and a limited or high power output setting. From the main screen, you can also turn on or off regen braking. And finally, you can also track your rides, which uses GPS and calculates total miles, ride time, and max speed. It also saves all your rides and displays a map so you can play back where you rode. Looking at the design, the X160 has a forged aluminum frame which keeps this dirt bike lightweight at 106 pounds. The battery weighs 18 pounds. For power, the Segway has 300 watts of nominal power, with a peak power of 3,000 watts. The motor is located on the bottom of the frame, below the battery, and near the foot pegs. This allows great weight distribution and a lower center of gravity, especially compared to most other e-bikes that have the battery much higher up on the frame. The motor is direct drive with a chain and large 48-tooth sprocket, which helps create a 23 foot-pounds of peak torque. Compared to most other e-bikes, that makes it quick. Just watch how it takes off the line next to the Super 73 RX, an e-bike with 2,000 watts of peak power. Looking at the battery, it's a 20 amp hour, 48 volt that sits at the center of the bike. You can easily open the latch, unplug the two harnesses, and pull the battery out. This makes it useful to store the bike in one place and bring the battery in to charge. It also helps reduce weight when carrying or loading the bike into a truck. For suspension, it has an adjustable 3-inch rear coil shock. For the front shocks, the X160 has a single crown adjustable air shock. We felt that the suspension on this bike handled everything that we put it through, but keep in mind that you can easily upgrade the shocks with newer, higher end ones. For brakes, the Segway X160 features both hydraulic front disc brakes, along with a regenerative braking that comes from the motor. You can feel the regen braking come on as soon as you let off the throttle, and it almost mimics the feel of what you would get from a two-stroke engine. We had our friend Evan, who rides a two-stroke KTM, ride the bike and put it through some tests. He is 6 feet tall and weighs 160 pounds. He rode in an area that includes loose sand, trail riding, and a few small jumps. Right away, he was really enjoying it. He particularly liked how quiet it was, allowing him to hear more of the ground and what's happening around the bike. Also, being able to stop when taking a break and hearing nothing is a whole new feeling, along with not having any heat coming from the bike. The power-to-weight ratio also means you can easily control it. It gives you more confidence on the trail, especially coming from a regular motocross bike, allowing you to hit features and push yourself where you normally wouldn't on a larger bike. Riding it in the sand, it rode through it easily and can quickly maneuver due to the light weight. However, the X160 only has 17-inch wheels and 70 by 100 tires, so at times the front wheel did struggle and get buried. Riding in the forest trails, you can really open it up and hit top speed quick. Hitting a few features, the suspension felt slightly stiff, but we also hadn't adjusted the preload and rebound. We did take one spill after trying to hop over a tree going almost full speed. Fortunately, he was fine, and surprisingly, the bike was fine as well, with no damage. The only thing we had to do was realign the handlebar, and the bike was ready to ride again. We also noticed the throttle automatically shut off and disabled when the bike fell, which is a great safety mechanism. Another advantage of the small weight of the bike is that if you do fall, you can dump the bike easily and get out of the way. For range, Segway advertises a range of up to 40 miles for the X160. However, we think it is exaggerated, and that type of range could only be achieved going very slow with a light rider in eco mode. For our riding, we rode for about 45 minutes of hard riding in sport mode with the settings maxed out. By the end of the ride, the bike was down to 10%, which causes it to go into limp mode, which dramatically reduces the power and top speed to 10 miles per hour. Separately, we did another street test for range. We rode on the street going 25 to 30 miles per hour for almost 8 miles to an off-road area. Once there, we rode for 2 to 3 miles for half an hour, and that brought the battery down to 10% and limp mode. Overall, the battery range is definitely a lot less than advertised, and something to consider since it takes 4 to 5 hours to fully charge a battery. We think this type of dirt bike would be more suitable for a backyard or nearby riding trails where you can quickly get to. For long trips and exploring far, you could easily get stranded. We took the bike down a long dirt road and rode in a sand pit with a lot of loose sand with heavy throttle, and it started taking the battery down 20% in just 5 to 10 minutes of riding there. This limited our time to ride and had us worried about getting back with enough battery. While the X160 is a quick and fun electric bike that is easy to master, it also makes it possible for more people to get out on the trails and get started. However, the X160 did leave us wanting for more, and we also felt the 17-inch wheels are too small for us and most adults. For us, this bike feels too small, so we will be upgrading and reviewing the Suron X that comes with 19-inch wheels and a bigger battery and motor. The Segway X160 is the smaller version of the Suron, but comes from the same factory. Segway offers the bigger version called the X260, while Suron has the X, which is the same bike, but without Bluetooth and an app. And it comes much cheaper at $3,600 from lunacycles.com. However, the Suron is known to sell out and could take months to ship. Meanwhile, we were able to get our X160 from Amazon on sale and delivered in just 3 days. We also think the X160 is a perfect beginner bike, especially for young teens and kids looking to get going quickly and progress. It also makes for a great second bike for anyone interested in e-bikes and what they have to offer. For accessories, we recommend upgrading the grips to Pro Taper pillow tops, along with upgrading the disc pads to Shimano. Since the X160 doesn't come with a light, we used our Surface front and rear LED lights, which easily fit on the front and rear. We'll leave links in the description to those accessories. Alright, that's it for now. If you're interested in the Suron, be sure to subscribe since we'll be reviewing it next. Let us know in the comments what you think and what you want to see in that video next.